you very much. A happy good evening to all members of the media and of course the folks from CTFA who have worked so diligently to bring this game to us in Tobago. It has been a pleasure working with TTFA to get this match to Tobago. I think it is a historic event for us. I think it's at least a decade since we've seen a match of this nature in Tobago. We wanted to make it our business to give Tobago a little bit of the action. We had seen two of the men games since the return to play in Trinidad. So I've been working with Mr. Haddad and the team from TTFA to bring this match to Tobago. It's all about showcasing our talent, showcasing to Trinidad and Tobago, especially to the youngsters, the different opportunities and the possibilities through sport. For many of the young people who came out today, for instance, my nephew is 7 years old and he had never seen girls play football. So this is quite an event for the youngsters to come out to see not just Trinidad and Tobago play, but to see women play. As a female minister of sport, it's important for me to promote and to push women in sport and to showcase to Trinidad and Tobago that women are capable and competent too. The return to play has been quite safe and successful, and I'm happy that national governing bodies, especially TTFA, have taken the opportunity to go out from the time we lifted the ban, allowing sports serving bodies and NGBs to play freely. TTFA was ready to roll. So I'm pleased to have played a role in getting NGBs out to play, especially TTFA. We move on to, I must say, I'm pleased by the turnout from Tobagonians who came out in their numbers and pretty much filled White York Stadium. This is the type of energy and excitement that is innate in Trinbagonians. That is why CPL want to come. That is why other sporting disciplines want to come to display their talent in front of an energetic crowd like this. We thank TTFA for the rhythm section and all the entertainment. And we look forward to seeing many more. We already started talking about bringing a men's game later on this year and in talks and started talks with Jamaica because we are celebrating 60 years of independence alongside Jamaica this year, so we can do something, hopefully a football game or something with athletics club. But we want to celebrate in a major way, bringing more games to Trinidad and Tobago, and especially Tobago, also getting Tobago in on the action, and bringing more women games. We also look at the men game in June. I want to thank particularly Sport TT, the folks at Sport TT, and Caribbean Airlines. As Kevin Jones said earlier, there have been some difficulties as it relates to a delayed flight and so on, and changing flights last minute and getting the players over to Tobago. Even the logistics to have the games come over to Tobago in such short time for planning. So it's about cooperation and communication and working consistently to ensure that it happens. So I want to salute Caribbean Airlines for just always being a phone call away and always being ready to assist. Kevin Jones, I must say, I'm always impressed not only by the way he has stood out and instilled discipline in these young ladies, but the way he treats football as business, the way he speaks about it, the way he communicates. I feel inspired. I feel excited to listen, to follow. And I think this signals a new day for sport in Trinidad and Tobago, because there are many other countries who are still struggling to get out and play successfully. So here we are in Trinidad and Tobago making it happen, and we have done so safely. We haven't seen any major spike in numbers due to the return to play. We have all age groups returning to play, both adults and young people. Today I was a part of a futsal training camp by Futsal 868 at Montgomery in Tobago. So in little pockets all over Trinidad and Tobago, our people are out, they are playing. We are happy to support, happy to sponsor, happy to participate, and most excited that we have successfully and safely returned to play. And I look forward to more action in Tobago, of course, and throughout Trinidad and Tobago.
Thank you very much, Minister. Are there any questions?
Yes, please. Tobago time.